Thanks. Thank you. Yeah, you know, people have heard about ESP and things like that, mind reading and transcendental meditation and all those kind of things. Yeah, there are experiments Dr. Ryan used to do them at Duke University. But, you know, he'd have somebody stay in one room and they'd look at a wall and they were able to tell what's happening in the other room, which would be great for the hotel business, wouldn't it? That'd be a wonderful idea. But, you know, we could kind of demonstrate that with a deck of cards. For example, if I wanted to separate the red cards from the black cards, it would be quite simple. I would simply turn the deck face up and I put the reds in one pile, the blacks in another, and the reds in the blacks and so forth. I mean, anybody could do that. I want to try something a little different. First of all, you know, the deck is being shuffled. But that's not enough. That's not good enough. People that watch me work really like to see a deck shuffled more. Do you know how to play bridge, Robin? I know you play poker. Do you know how to play bridge? Well, it doesn't really matter. All you need to know is that in bridge you deal out four hands, like this, usually. That's what I'm going to ask you to do. I'm going to give you the deck of cards. I'm going to ask you to start dealing out the four hands. But then, anytime you like, start dealing backwards, diagonally, haphazardly, any way you like, okay? It's just one silly way of shuffling cards, and then we'll do some more. But right now, that's what I'd like you to do. So start the deal out of forehand bridge game. Right. You can keep going or start to go any way you like, but we can try to keep the piles even, but that's not even necessary. You don't have to count them, but you can go in any direction you want. In other words, really mix them. Go diagonally, backwards, forwards, any way you like. That's it. Do it as quickly as you like and any way you like. You're doing very well. I'd hate to play cards with her. That's very good, Robin. It really is. You're doing well. As I say, you can go in any direction, just so you don't think I'm planning anything. That's the whole point. And you did very well. Okay, what I want you to do now, we have four approximately equal packets because you didn't go evenly. I would like you to point to any two of these. These two. Would you take those two? Well, I'm going to do it for you first, and then you do it with the other two. What I'm going to ask is to kind of riffle shuffle them into each other like that, kind of neatly. I want everyone to see that they're really shuffled together. Look, now you do it with the two remaining ones if you would. Try to do it real neatly if you can. Now, that's it. Square, put them to really want them shuffled. Now what I'd like you to do is take these two half decks and riffle shuffle those into each other as neatly as you can. That's fine. You're doing well. Now, would you agree that this deck is shuffled? Okay. Remember what I talked to you about before, about separating the reds and blacks? If I were to put a red card right here, and if I would put these are very slippy, so pardon me, and if I were to put a black card right here, they would sort of constitute leader cards. In other words, I can help you with a few, but I won't do that. As a matter of fact, you know what I realized? This is silly. You can remember reds on your left and blacks on your right, can't you? You can do that. You don't need idiot cards like that. Okay, take that deck. If you think it's red, put it on your left. If you think it's black, put it on your right. And do it as quickly as you like. I want you to go by first impulse. You're doing very well. That's it. Any way you like. Remember, these are reds, and you can put them together because you're in your own room. That's it. Hold it. See, you went too fast. That's a black. That belongs there. But don't let that throw you. I just don't want you to get too overconfident. Hey, go as quickly as you like, and I won't stop you in the middle. I don't care how you do it, but one card at a time. She's doing quite well. You're going by first impulse, aren't you? Because those impulses are wonderful. You're doing great. You really are. That's wonderful. But that's it. Any way you like. Yeah. Anyway, it's okay. I don't care. Harvey. Now, I'm going to do something that I don't think anybody has ever done before. If I were to show you right now that all the reds were in one pile and all the blacks in the other pile, I know you wouldn't believe me. But I'm going to take these cards the way you just put them down, and I will shuffle them into each other like this. I don't think that deck has been shuffled a million times. Would you do this for me, Robin? Pick up the deck and start to deal them down here one at a time. I'll tell you when to stop. Yeah, that's enough. Start the deal here now. Faster if you like. That's good enough. Drop the rest over here. If I picked up any one of these, and if I told you, for example, that there were exactly 20 cards here, it wouldn't be much of a trick because you say, well, what the heck, you counted them while I was dealing them. But if I told you that there were exactly 10 reds and 10 blacks here, do you think that would be a good trick? Let's see. Let's count the reds. They happen to be on a face. Look, there's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. You missed by one. You've got 9 here. But you know why that doesn't matter? It doesn't matter because look what else you did. You actually separated every one of your reds from every one of your blacks, and that's good.